Hi friends, my name is Gunjan and welcome to my channel. I guess today's recipe is going to be everybody's favorite. It's cheesecake and the best part about it is it's going to be 1 minute microwave keto cheesecake. It's super delicious. It tastes exactly like baked keto cheesecake. It's super yum. And the success to get this right is to use exact and accurate ingredients with precise measurement. So please do watch this video carefully. Do not skip any of the part so that you don't get this wrong and you get the perfect, nice, creamy textured keto cheesecake. So without any further delay, let's go ahead and check out the recipe. And before that, if you are new to my channel, a very warm welcome. Please subscribe to my channel and let's go ahead and see the recipe. So as I mentioned earlier, it is super important to be very precise for this 1 minute keto cheesecake. That's why here I am measuring my cream cheese and I need 140 gram of cream cheese. So once it's 140 gram, so it's done. So let me keep my weighing scale aside, and now into this I will crack open one large room temperature egg. My cream cheese is also room temperature. So now with the help of my fork, I am going to mash the cream cheese and I will try to blend this with my egg. Here, alternatively, you can definitely use a hand blender, but I assume that not everybody has a hand blender. That's why I wanted to show you how to make our 1 minute microwave keto cheesecake in a simplest way. That's why I'm using my fork right now. Once eggs and cream cheese is coarsely combined, I am going to add half a teaspoon of vanilla extract to this, and in goes our half a teaspoon of vanilla extract. And next I am going to use 2 tablespoons of powder sweetener. It is mixed of stevia and monk fruit. If you don't have powder sweetener, what you can do is you can run your granular sweetener into your blender so it will come to a powder form. Powder sweetener is really important for this keto microwave cheesecake, because if you use granular one, your cheesecake will not be that great. So that's why make sure that you're using the powder sweetener and give this all a good mix. Now I think I have realized that the fork is not doing a great job. Now with the help of my spatula, I am trying to smooth out the batter as much as possible. It's a real labor intensive job and a good arm workout for me, but you are free to use your hand blender as I mentioned earlier. And finally, I guess I did a good job. You can see the batter is nice, smooth and creamy. Let me keep this aside. Now here I have got 2 medium-sized ramekins and I need to grease it. It's really important to grease it if you want to unmold your cheesecake. If you don't want to unmold your cheesecake and if you want to eat it from your ramekin, then it's okay, skip this part. But here I am greasing my ramekin with olive oil. And next, our cream cheese batter goes into our ramekins. I'm equally dividing my cream cheese batter into 2 ramekins. And let me scrape off whatever extra is stuck on my spatula. And now I'm going to even out the surface of my cream cheese so that it's equally and evenly spread. Tap this a little on your kitchen top so that it is equally spread. And next, it goes into our microwave. Now I am not going to microwave it 1 minute straight. What I'm going to do is I'm first going to microwave this for 30 seconds and see. And after 30 seconds, you can see our cheesecake has begun to set, but it's not completely set. So now I will go ahead and cook this for another 10 seconds and then we'll see. And after 10 seconds, you can see our edges has cooked nicely. But I think I will give 5 seconds more to this cheesecake, so I'm going to put this again into my microwave for 5 more seconds. And after 5 seconds,
all the edges are nicely set, but you can see the center is still jiggly. Let me shake it off and show it to you. Can you see the center is still jiggly? But that's okay, this is how it should be. And here I have microwaved both of my ramekins, and next this goes into my fridge for chilling. And after 1 hour, I have inverted my cheesecake onto this plate, and you can see the texture. It's really nice, smooth and creamy. And let me slice a bite so that I can show you how creamy, how dense and how rich it is. So this is our 1 minute keto microwave cheesecake. I hope you like the recipe. Please subscribe to my channel for more such recipes. Thank you.